So we are in the Semicha program and we are in Siman Kuf Nun Tet, or Chaim Kuf Nun Tet, paragraph Tet. We did yesterday the two, and we need to do the Bet Yosef. Right? So the subject matter is when you have a big barrel that is too heavy for you to pick it up to wash the hands from it. Yeah? So you need something, you know,
smaller clean.
You don't have a smaller clean. Right? So what you do, you put it on your knees and you tilt it. Yeah, you put it on your knees and you tilt it on the hand without picking it up, and that's fine. Why? Because the fact that you are tilting it, that considered to be the man's power that is causing the water to flow on your hands. That's fine. Okay, so I'm reading the
Shel Netilat Yadayim?
Halachot Netilat Yadayim, yes. Perek Kama Yadayim, I'm reading it by Yosef. Now, Meniach Chavit Ben Berkav Venotel Venotel. Umate Chavit Al Tzida Venotel. Right? So again, that's a clear Mishnah in Tractate Yadayim, that it says you can do it in this way, put it on your knees and tilt it, and that will be count as washing hands. Ve'akof notel yadayim. Okay, according to the Mishnah, if you can train a monkey to wash your hands, and that will be fine.
Ooh.
Yeah? Very good. Rabbi Yossi posel b'shnei elu. According to Rabbi Yossi, both of those possibilities are not good.
Oh.
It's not a way to wash hands. Yiresh Rabbeinu Shimshon. So according to the commentary of Rabbeinu Shimshon, which is one of the Rishonim, Mate achavit al tzida venotel, if you're tilting the barrel on the side, and that's the way you wash, lo dami le'ad amar av papa, it's not similar to what we have in the Gemara in Chulin Kuf Zayin A. It says there, I reata the delay and not limen ol yadayim. Right? So there we're speaking about some kind of a pipe that is pouring the water. Da'atam shofech min adav la letzinorot shamayim noflim min atzinorot el adav. Right? That was the previous paragraph. That there's a guy that is pouring with a bucket on a water channel, and then you're standing further on in the end of the water channel and you're putting the hands in the stream, so that doesn't count as washing hands, right? As we learned previously. Then and the chashuv mikoach gavra. So there we say, what's the missing link, why it's not good netilat yadayim? Because you don't have the man's power that is active on the water. אבל הכוח שאדם עצמו הייתה חבית. But here when we're talking about the case that you're tilting the barrel, אפילו הלך וישב לו אחר כך, even though that afterwards you go sit down and the barrel continue to flow, החבית שופכת מים כל היום מחמת התאטון. So you tilt it like one time, a little bit, and it continued to flow. I don't know exactly how can it be, but whatever. But if that's the case, thank you very much. That will be okay. Why? Because it is man's power that caused it to be tilled, right? No problem. אבל הכוח כוח גבר. אינמי הייתן דמחשב בקוף. Now what about this monkey? So he says, לא חי שכוח גבר. So when he says that monkey can wash your hands and it will be fine, it means, according to him, it's not necessary to have the man's power. Yeah? When we say monkey, it doesn't have to be monkey. It can be also machinery. It can be a robot. All of those different things is the same thing for us. It means someone that he doesn't have the consciousness, yeah, of human being. What about okay, we'll discuss the different possibilities further on. But Sugya de'atam ki Rabbi Yossi shepusel b'shne'elu. We have the halacha not like this opinion that says that the monkey is kosher. We said the halacha is like Rabbi Yossi that says that both of those possibilities are not good. Klamar mateh chavitu bechof. So also tilting the barrel and also the monkey. Tamad raveu mishum debay koach gavra. And the reason for both of them that we say it's not good because it's missing the man's power. Aval maniach chavit al berkav sheberkav mesein lo lishpor. What about this case here that you're putting the barrel on your knees and then with the knees it makes it that it will be tilled? So that's the man's power, even though it's coming from the knees and not from the hands, but still it's man's power that is causing the barrel to flow. Okay, so all of that was the words of Rabbeinu Shimon. כבר גדלתי בסמוך שדעת התוספות והראש לפסוק כרבי יוסי. According to תוספות and ראיין, the ראש, the הלכה is like רבי יוסי. חן דעת הרייבת ורבנו אינה. Right? So we have many ראשונים. סמק, תרומה, all of those different sources, they say like רבי יוסי. What they would say about the monkey, I'm not sure. But anyhow, אבל הרמב״ם פוסק את הנקמה, according to the רמב״ם, להלכה is like תנקמה, meaning the monkey is out.
רמב״ם,
yeah, Maimonides, they call him. Yes. כתב הרבנו יונה פרק אלו דברים שכך נראה שהוא דעת רב יהודה גאון. The רבנו יונה also brings from the רב יהודה גאון, the גאונים was the previous generation before the ראשונים. כן דעת הרשב"א, also the Rashba, פרק על הבשר, that he writes about it in Chulin, in the commentary on the Gemara, and also in his Halacha book that is called Torah Tabayit, both of those sources. אבל בי שהרמב"ם פוסק את הנקמה, even though the Rambam is saying the Halacha is like תנקמה, היינו לומר the לא בעינן כוח גברא, meaning that you don't need man's power, אבל כוח נותן מי הבאי. But you need to have the power that is of someone that is initiating that pouring of the water, כמובן שם בדבריו, like it is explained in the words of the Rambam, din shoket, that it says, it speaks about the shoket. Shoket is what I was saying yesterday, I'm not sure how to call it in English, but the like a big vessel, a big tray that they're giving the animals to drink from. You have a special name for
trough,
that?
Trough, animal trough.
Trough?
Trough, T-H-R-O-U-T-H.
Trough.
Yeah.
Okay.
So like the five horses drink the water from it.
Yeah. Trough?
Trough.
Okay. So that's
shoket?
Yeah. In Hebrew it's called shoket. Okay. וצריך לומר שמפרש כפרוש כמה דרבנו שמעון דמתי חבית ונוטל שפיר כוח גברה. So according to that it seems that he's going with רבנו שמעון, that he says that putting the barrel on your knees and washing from that, that's no problem. It is the power of someone that is pouring, okay? You see that there is a certain split here between those two concepts. When man's power is one thing, and koach noten, a power that gives over the pouring, is something else. So if you don't need the man's power, you just need the koach noten, the power of someone that is pouring. So then also a monkey is koach noten. There is some kind of force that is forcing the water to, לעניין הלכה כיוון הנליזה דם דרבנן הקטינן כי הרמב״ם והרשב״ם ורב יהודה תפסקו קטן הקמה. So he says that because this whole set of הלכות of נטילת ידיים is rabbinic, right? Until we will have בית המקדש בעזרת השם soon, and then the כהנים will have to wash when they coming into the בית המקדש, right? So then it will be deoraita. But right now when we're washing the hands is rabbinic, right? So because it's rabbinic, so we can be lenient like the first opinion in the Mishnah in Masechet Yadayim. Okay, we have a little Darkei Moshe here, Darkei Moshe Gimel. ולא נראה כלל לדחות דברי כל הנרבות הקדמי ובטרי. Says רבנו משה איסרליש, how can you push away all of those opinions of great rabbis like just like that? אלא נקטינו לחומרה. So the opinion of the Darkei Moshe is to be stringent about it. אף על גב דלא אבי אלא איסור דרבנן, even though it is forbidden of rabbinic prohibition, but אין זה ספק דרבנן ללך לכולה. So when do we say that because it's rabbinic, so we're going to be lenient? That's when we have a case of a doubt. That we have one situation, and you can give it different interpretations. So then, if it is rabbinic, so you can be lenient. But here, that's not the case. You have a requirement, rabbinic requirement, to wash the hands, and we have to be stringent about it. That's what says the Kei Moshe. So you see that there's a certain argument between the Rabbi Moshe Yosef Karo and Rama about what is the concept of Safek de Rabbanan Lekula. Yeah, we have a concept like that. Everybody agrees about it. It's brought down in the Gemara. But the question is, when is the doubt that in that doubt will be lenient? So according to the Bet Yosef, here is a case of a doubt, rabbinic doubt, so we can be lenient. Rama says, no, that's not a case of a doubt. It's not called a doubt. So you have to be stringent. Oil v'rabim batrai machmirim anu navid kevateu. So because there's many opinions that are stringent, so the Rama says we will follow them. Okay. We're going to see it soon in the Shulchan Aruch. Continuing in the Bet Yosef, מה שאמר רבנו, אבל אם היה ברזה בנקה וסירו וקיבל המים. So again, we're talking about a barrel that have a hole in the bottom, and in that hole they push a stick to block the water, and that is the kind of taps that they had in their times. So every time you want water, you pull out the stick, and then the water flows, right? So if you do it like that, you pulling the stick, you putting the hand, flows on the hand, then you push it back, then you pull it with the other hand, so that will be count as washing hands. That's what we spoke about yesterday in the two. It says that the source of that is the Rosh in Perkel Abasa, Kenikitav Mordechi, Perkel Udvarim, Kenvogot Maimoniot. So he brings here all of those different rabbis that they spoke about this halacha. Smak, Sefer HaTurma, right? All of those are permitting to wash the hands in this way. But the machshirin and liton michavit sheyesh banekev. Why are we allowing to wash from a barrel that have a hole? We just said a few paragraphs ago that if you have a hole in the bucket, so the bucket is not good, it's not called a vessel, and you need to wash from a vessel. So what's going on? How can you wash from a barrel like that have a hole? Right? למטה מקבל רביעית, הלאו הכי פסול, the love clear, right? It's not good, it's not a vessel. לדעת הסמג, the ניקב וכונס משקה, love clear, הוא פסול. So that's opinion that we spoke about before, that when you have the measurement of a hole that liquid will come in, it's called כונס משקה. So it prevents it from being a vessel, and then if it's not a vessel, you can't use it for washing hands. אפילו דרך הנגב צריך לומר, דהד מכשירינו בחבית שיש בנקב, ובו ברזה. So according to that, you will have to say that when we're speaking about this barrel that have a hole for the tap, שהנקב פחות מכונס משקה דווקא. That the hole is so small that is not in that measurement that destroys the concept of a vessel there. And it's very hard to say that. Who wants to use a tap that the opening of the tap is so small that you have just like a little drizzle that is coming out of that? So it's not.
Is it one kernel of barley?
It's something like that. It's like.
No, it's a pea?
It's not. Lentil. It's. Lentil. The lentil is bigger than that. It's smaller than a lentil. Smaller than a lentil. Anyhow.
Not practical.
It's not something that you want to wash hands from. Right. Okay, so that's what the Chaber says. It's very hard to say. לכן צריך לומר. So we have to say, the chavit nekuva sheyesh beberza benekev chashiv shapir kli. That even though we have a hole in the bottom of this barrel still is called a vessel. Okay, so how so? It has a hole. כיוון שעשוי לקבלה בעניין זה. This is the key line. That it is made that it will receive the liquids in this way. This barrel is made specifically for that purpose. They make it with a hole. So it's kind of a vessel. This is the shape of the vessel. A vessel with a hole in the end. So the whole doesn't make it that it won't be a vessel, because that's the whole definition, that's the whole usage of this vessel. כמו שגדל רבנו בשם הראש, בכלי שהוא מלא נקבים מתחתיו ופיו צר למעלה. And we have like some kind of a vessel that I don't think that anyone have today, but they had in their time, that we spoke about before, that it's something that is like a cone that have like holes in the bottom, and then they fill it with water and hold it with the finger, with the vacuum, so the liquid stays inside of the vessel, and then they open the air
funnel.
They open the air, and then the water comes out. It's like upside down funnel with holes, like with a strainer in the end. Something like, I don't know exactly what they used it for. Maybe just for fun to make like you know the kids amused, whatever. But they had some kind of vessel there. So there we said that even though it has full of holes, but this is the way of this vessel. So you can't say it's not a vessel. It's a vessel. People are using it. כיוון שעשו לקבלה בניין זה, ועיקר תשמישו נקרא כלי. So again, the point is that it will be designated to be used in this way. So when do we say that the hole destroys the vessel from being a vessel? That it was not supposed to be used in this way. And then it got a hole. Then it's not a vessel anymore. Right? And this is explaining the difficulties that we had before. Excuse me. Baruch. So. Says the Bet Yosef, it's difficult for me to understand all those rabbis that we said their names. How is it possible that it will be permitted to wash hands in this way that you're pulling and pushing back this stick and that will be count? Yeah. It's going back to the question again. I'm not sure why he's doing that. We already answered that. Okay, so he's saying over the question that we said the answer for. That why is it permitted? It's not a vessel. Okay. אינו כלי, נמצא שהמים נופלים על ידיו ואינם באים מכוח כלי, כלל, אלא על כוח הוא אמר, כיוון שעשו לקבלה בעניין זה, וזה יקרב תשמישו, נקרא כלי. So you must say what we explained, that because it is made in this way, that it will be used with the hole, so therefore it's not destroying that from being a vessel, and that will be fine. Good. So now, after we got that pretty much clear, we can go to the Mishnah Brura, Shulchan Aruch Mishnah Brura. Okay. Where's my sticker? Still somewhere. Kuf Nun Tet, Seif Tet, right? Here it is. Okay. Kuf Nun Tet, Seif Tet. Shulchan Aruch. Chavit sheyesh ba mayim menichal berkav venotel limena ladayim. A barrel that is full of water, you put it on your knees and you can wash your hands from it. Ve'im hayta muta ba'aretz, if it is tilled on the ground, ve'amayim mekalchim mena, and the water is splashing from it. או שעומדת והמים יוצאים דרך נקב שבה, or maybe it stands and the water is coming out of the hole. ונתן ידיו שם, and you're putting your hands there, לא עלתה לו נטילה, it doesn't count as washing hands. ואם הייתה ברזה, if there is a tap there, פירוש דבר הסותם הנקב, something that blocks the hole, כנגב בנקב, והסירה וקיבל המים על ידיו, and then you remove that blockage and the water are coming pouring on your hands. Chashiv shapir koach gavra, it counts as the man's power. וצריך להחזירה או להסירה וכל שפיכה ושפיכה, you have to remove it and put it back every time you're pouring on your hands. משנה ברורה, נון חט.
Yeah, I don't know.
going to help him?
Keep teaching.
Okay. דרוצה ליטול שני ידיו כאחד, ואין לו אחר שיטול עליהם. Okay? So, the Mishnah Berurah is explaining that the case we're speaking about when he's putting the barrel on his knees is when he wants to wash the two hands together in the same time. Okay, for us, usually we got the custom of putting one hand and the other hand, right? But there is also a way, we'll see that in some ways it is preferable to wash the two hands together. So this guy, that's what he wants to do. He wants to wash the two hands together. And he doesn't have another person that will pull on his hands. So he wants to put the barrel on his knees and that in with the legs to pull on the hands. Yeah. So he's moving his knees every time to pour the water with the movement of the knees that it will splash on the hands. And we say that this is no problem with it. Yeah? If he made it that the water will reach all the hands, no problem with it. Yeah? Just the problem might be that if with his legs he doesn't have the full control, and then when the water are pouring is not like exactly putting the hands under the water or whatever, and then it will be a problem.
What did
but
you mean by
if
putting them on the legs, moving the knees, like what is he doing?
He's putting it between the knees and then moving the knees the different
vessel,
direction,
right.
So he's like causing the barrel to move and then it's splashing the water. Might be a little messy. I don't know like why a person would want to do that, but if that's what he did, it's kosher. Okay. So what's the reason it's so kosher? Because you have a vessel, the barrel, and you have the man's power that is moving the vessel and pouring the water. Okay. לפי מה שכתב המחבר, לכמה מסימי סעיף יוד. If he did only one movement, and then the water is pouring from that one movement, and is washing the hands like few times in that one pouring, so that's בדיעבד, that's not לכתחילה. Okay, we'll speak about it further on in the next paragraph. The next case is when it is on the ground and it is tilled and it pours by itself. מותר בארץ שלא על ידי אדם, not by man, it's not tilled by man, אלא מעצמה מתרגלה, just moved by itself and the water they are pouring from there. דהילו בא הקילוח מתחילה על ידי הטיית אדם. If it was originally by man's that pushed it, מכשיר המחבר לכמן סעיף י' דחשיב כוח גברה. In the next paragraph, we'll see that the Shulchan Aruch says it is permitted. It's called a man's power. דרך הנקב שבא, through the hole in that שנעשה בשביל ברזה, the hole that was made for the tap. נפל הברזה, and the tap fell down, המים יוצאים מעצמם, and the water are pouring by themselves. Okay? The reason the Mishnah Berurah is emphasizing that the hole was there for a tap and now there's no tap, because if there's a hole that was not done for a tap, so it's the hole that it destroys the vessel and then it's not good to wash from that. לא עלתה וצריך שיבואו על ידם מכוח איזה נותן ולא שיבואו מאליהם. Right? We said that we need to have the power of someone that is pouring the water and know that it will come by itself. חשיב שפיר כיוון על ידי הסרתו מקלחין המים. Why removing the blockage is called man's power? That by removing the blockage, yes, then that's what causing the water to splash. So that's good. כל השפיכה שפיכה, every time he's pouring the water on the hands, ירוש בכל כילוח וכילוח, דלא חשבינן בזה במגרו. We don't count it that it's coming from his own power, אלא כילוח ראשון, only the first pouring. על כן צריך לחזור ולעשר בכל השפיכה שפיכה, that's why you need to remove and put back every time. כתבו האחרונים דענותה לידי כלי, the later rabbis wrote that if you washing the hands by a vessel שמותקן על ידי הברזל, that there's iron that is there, קוראים תרנגול, או מה שקוראים קרן. Okay, that's what we call tap. A regular tap, צריך לסגור ולפתוח כמה פעמים לכל יד ויד. You have to open and close a few times for each hand. דהודק ואינו מספיק בקילוח ראשון ליטול יד כראוי. And it's also another point that is saying here that it depends which tap we're talking about, but it might be a tap that the hole is so narrow that it's not enough pouring on the water to cover the hand in one opening. So you open and it's pouring, but it's just like small, so it's not enough. So then you have to, how long can you give it that it will flow to pour in the whole hand, and count the man's power that you opened it first, that's the reason that this keep on flowing, right? So we have to open close for one hand, even not only for like when you switching from one hand to another in this case. Okay, paragraph Yud. Imita chavit mele'a mayim, if you are tilting a barrel that is full of water, v'alach v'yashav lo, and you go away, v'chavit shoferet mayim kol hayom mechamat ha'teto, and this barrel is keeping on pouring water the whole day because of the first push that you pushed it in the morning, natale da v'meno, and you yourself or other people are coming and washing the hands from that, altala netila, it counts as washing. Imita afilu eicha shamate chavit haya adam acher, even though the person that tilled it was a different person, lo kiven klal bezel netila machsheret lachila, and when he tilled it, he didn't have in mind that people will wash hands for purpose of eating from that, afilu ach isha birdami, still it will be kosher. Why? Even the Adam notel yadav, because a man that is washing his hands afterwards, achakach, kiven leshem netila, he had in mind for washing for the bread, so therefore it is considered to be a good washing. The bekavanat noten or notel sagi, that you need to have the intention, or of the person that is pouring the water, or the person that is washing his hands. One of them is enough. You don't need that both of them will have the intention that this pouring of water will qualify the hands for eating. One is enough. Okay. Alach v'yashav, ve'lo dami lema shemvar b'seif tet. So the Mishnah Berurah is explaining why we have to discuss it after we already spoke about something similar in the previous paragraph. Nekoach gamra nechshav rak ha-kiluach rishon. Here we have the man's power, which is the first pouring of the water, levad. So that's why you need to place it back, the blockage, every time you want to have another pouring. The Adam lo asam maaseh beguf ha-mayim, because there it was not, he didn't do anything about the water themselves. Here you only remove the tap, the blockage, so then it's causing the water to flow, but you didn't move the water themselves, right? When you're tilting the barrel, so it's moving all the water.
You're opening the
so
tap,
that's the difference between the two cases.
Right, this is between moving the barrel or opening a tap water.
Right. Yeah. לכן לא חשיב בא מכוחו רק כילוח ראשון יוצא מיד כשפותחו. So what do we count as that it's coming from his power? Just the first splash of the water that comes when he's opening the tap. אבל אחר שעשה מעשה בגוף המים שהניע אותם מחמת הדייתו נשפחים, but in the first case that you are moving the barrel and then from all of the water that are splashing, it's because of the first tilting that you did. As long as it pours from the barrel, it will be counted that it's coming from the original power that tilled the barrel. Alta la netila, en biur halacha shetov leachmir bazeh lechatchila. The biur halacha explains that it's good to be stringent about it. About what?
Alta
la netila. Okay. So here in the He brings the opinion of the Vilna Gaon. The Vilna Gaon explains, אם כן המחמירים שמה חינם מכאן. Okay. Yeah, there's a certain like missing point here. The what is the stringency that he's talking about? The case that he was speaking about, that the mechaber is lenient and the Mishnah Berurah says to be stringent, is when one guy tilled the barrel in the morning and then the same person or other people through the day are washing the hand from that water that are pouring from the barrel because of the first tilting, right? So the Mechaber says, no problem, do it, lechatchila. And the Mishnah Berurah says, it's not so good, you have to be stringent if you can.
And this is about the bucket?
That's about big barrel that somebody, I guess a strong guy, pushed it in the morning and it was pouring. Shalom Aleichem.
Thank you.
Someone was tilted in the morning and is pouring on the hands of many people, and it's all count from the man's power of the person that tilted in the first time. Okay?
I don't. There's a big bucket.
Yeah.
A strong man comes, pushes it over, and one by one the people go and they wash their hands?
Yeah.
How could that be a problem?
How can it be
a problem?
Why would it be a problem?
Yeah.
So the point here that it is,
the question is
all the water that are pouring is coming from their first movement of the tilting of the first person. So
the person leaves?
The person leaves. Yeah.
That's the problem, okay.
Went away, whatever, that's not the point. The point is that we have like barrel that is tilled from the power of someone that tilled it, yes. So how long can you say that people can go there and wash hands from this water that are pouring? So according to the Mechaber, no problem, all day long, from morning to evening, you can have like many people washing their hands there, yeah? But the Mishnah Berurah says it's not so simple. You have to be stringent not to do it in this way. It's not lechatchila. Okay, and he brings the opinion of the Vilna Gaon that it's better to be stringent. Lechatchila. Excuse me. Okay. Yud Alef. Okay. Here, the next paragraph was Yud Bet, and then we have Yud Aleph. So it's a little bit confusing here. Okay, I guess we'll do it here, and then we'll go back to the Shulchan Aruch Mishnah Berurah. It's too hot for you? You can put it down a little bit.
No. Sit somewhere else.
Okay. Yud Bet. You have with me the two Kuf Nun Tet, paragraph Yud Bet. Kof Pasul Liten Ledain. A monkey or a robot or anything else that doesn't have human consciousness is not good for washing hands. And then the next paragraph, Aval Kol Adam, Filu Chereshote Katan Goy Onida Ksherin. But any human being, doesn't matter which, so is giving few cases that is like a to describe, but basically any human being is kosher for washing hands. So he's saying a mute, and when he's speaking about a mute, so we say it's someone that is not able to hear, not able to speak. Yeah. So a mute, a fool, a minor, non-Jew, neither woman, all of those different possibilities, all kosher for washing hands. Okay.
Wouldn't the neither woman attract, like, bring the tumor? Oh, I don't know, because I guess the vessel wouldn't, and the vessel wouldn't transfer the tumor to the water, to the hands.
Okay. If we would have been in a situation that we have Beit HaMikdash, Bezrat Hashem soon, And we have to keep ourselves pure to be able to bring the sacrifices, eat the sacrifices if we are kohanim, whatever, all of those different like applications of purity of the when Beit HaMikdash exists. So then your question would have been like halachic question. Okay, but today that we don't have all of that, so we're not keeping like the all of those rules of purity. So the question is not about the purity, it's about is the washing of the hands is called washing of the hands. You can eat now or you can't eat now. So the answer is it's washing of the hands, you can eat now. No problem.
When your wife has Bezrat Hashem cooks for you when she's nida, you can still eat. You don't have to wait. Yeah.
There's some people who
yeah, but in time of Beit HaMikdash you have to learn how to cook for yourself. Okay. Yudalef, in the two. Yudalef in the Bet Yosef. Yudalef, it's Yudalef to Yud Gimel together. It's a long Bet Yosef. Okay? Kof pasul liten edayim. A monkey is not good to wash hands. Kfar nber besamuch, shu machloket tana kamer Rabbi Yossi, shatos ודברוש, kamer גדולים פוסקים Rabbi Yossi, de pasal. Rabbi Yudu ורש, וברמב"ם, פסקו תנא קמא דמחשב. So he said that this monkey business is about
so to speak
it's a machloket of Tana Kama and Rabbi Yossi in the tractate of Yadayim, and we have different rishonim, specifically Tosfot Rosh and a few others that are poskin like Rabbi Yossi, that he says it's not good, you can't have monkey washing your hands, and you have a few other poskim which is Rabbi Yehuda, Rashba, and Rambam that says that it's allowed. Okay, so that's what we said before. Katuv be'agat Ashri. Agat Ashri is one of the commentaries on the Rosh. The Rosh is the father of the two, right? Agat Ashri, Perek Bet Devarachot, Akol Ksherim Liten Leadayim, Afilu Cheresh Oter Katan, Kvar Kebar Shit, Ukebar Sheva. Okay, so there, the Agat Ashri, he says that everybody are qualified to wash hands. So, and when he speaks about the minor, he says a minor that is 6 or 7 years old. So then according to that, the question will be, what about a minor that is 5 years old, 4 years old? It seems that if you're specific with the words of the Gaot Ashri, you can say that according to Gaot Ashri, it will be no good, will be pasul. נראה שהוא סובר דבעין אין כוונת נותן וחירי שוטה. יש להם כוונה. לכן קטן בר שיט. So the Beit Yosef is explaining what's the reasoning behind the Agot Ashri. He says that the Agot Ashri holds that the person that is pouring the water have to have some intention. So a minor that is less than 6 years old, he doesn't have even this minimum intention. And a fool and a mute, they are able to have this minimum intention. So then it will be okay. Okay? Again, when we're speaking about the fool here, we're talking about a fool that is healthy enough that you can ask him to wash your hands. Mm. Right? If he's out, so you can't ask him to wash your hands. It won't be, you won't do it because
it's
not...
Run away or scream or
the kavanah is basically I'm washing your hands or I'm washing your hands for netilat yadayim.
I think that he doesn't have to understand what is netilat yadayim.
He
knows that he's washing your hands.
Mm-hmm. He knows that he's pouring.
Okay, so he says that someone that is don't have that, so he says avikikof be'alma, so that's like a monkey that doesn't have any intention, have any understanding. גדלתי לפרש דברי הגאות, אבל עניין הלכה כבר כתבתי נקטינן כתנא קמא. So we are good doing the הלכה like תנא קמא. Okay.
Which is the monkey doesn't work.
Yeah. אבל כל אדם חירש ושוטה וקטן, פרק קמא דידיים, הכל קשירים ניתן לידיים, אפילו חירש ושוטה וקטן. So again, we're going on the explaining the Mishnah in מסכת ידיים. כתב רבנו שמעון ותוספתא ביי רבי יוסי כוונת נותן ונוטל. So according to Rabbi Shimon explains that Rabbi Yossi wants to have the intention of the person that is pouring the water and the person that is washing the hands, both of them. וזה לשון התוספתא. This is the words of the תוספתא. נוטל ומכוון ונותן, the poor, the one, the person that pours the water have the intention, ונותן אין מתכוון, and the person that is receiving the water doesn't have the intention, ונותן מתכוון, or the person that is pouring have the intention, ונותן אין מתכוון, and the other person doesn't have the intention. In both of those cases, ידיו טהורות, the hands are pure, says Tana Kama. Rabbi Yossi אומר, ידיו טמאות, according to Rabbi Yossi, the hands are not pure. Why? Because you don't have any of them intention. You don't have both of them. Meaning you need to have both of them, according to Rabbi Yossi. According to Tana Kama, it's enough to have one of the sides that have the intention. That will be sufficient. Rashba b'Torat HaBayit Pasak et Tana Kama. According to the Rashba, we go hold by Tana Kama. Efshar Rabbeinu Shimshon, Nami Yachas V'Ralein. It's possible that also Rabbi Shimshon is also according to this way. Ela Sheba Liyeshev, and is coming to explain that Nan Stam Acher Shoter Katan Onlim L'Adayim. So he's explaining the Mishnah. Why the Mishnah is saying that? Not to say that that's his opinion for Halacha. V'lo Palig Rabbi Yossi. And then he's not arguing with Rabbi Yossi. Inami afilu in tibzi lomar da alacha ki Rabbi Yossi. And even if you want to say that alacha is like Rabbi Yossi, that both of them need the intention, ikalamei me'ar, da'ainu le'achila truma b'davka. Maybe Rabbi Yossi is talking about eating truma. And then you need a higher level of purity, then you need the intention of both of them. Aval achilat chulin, but when you're talking about the rabbinic washing hands, which is for chulin, regular food, לא באין הכוונה, you don't have to have all of these intentions. By the way, side note, you see from that, that extra intention brings extra purity, right? So, as much as you have more intention when you're washing your hands, you're getting more purity to your hands.
The question isn't if it works, the question is it necessary?
Right, but I'm saying as a side note, that not talking halacha,
yes, just
like someone that he wants to have more purity when he eats, so when he's washing the hands, he have to have the like full intention, right? So, for example, someone that is like speaking with his friend while he's washing the hands, halachically is fine. He washed the hands, no problem. But he's not getting the full potential purity that is possible to get with his washing of the hands because he's not focused. He doesn't have the full intention. As much as you have more intention, it's better.
Is it,
what?
Is it better to have somebody else pour the water in your hands?
There is a benefit with it. We'll see further on. Da, perek bed, chulin amrinan, daval veluch zak, mutar lechulin. So it says, in chulin, in Lamed Aleph 31b, that if a person went to the mikveh and he didn't get the status of purity, he's still permitted to eat chulin. Okay, I have to explain what does it mean. So, like I just said, the intention creates levels of purity, right? So that's what he's saying here. If a person goes to the mikveh to eat, for example, truma. Truma is the first level of kodesh, right? He thinks all the food that he have to eat is only truma. That's what he have in his house. So he is going to the mikveh in the purpose of eating truma. Okay, so that's a certain level of purity. Now, thank you very much. Now, he's coming home, and his friend tells him, "Hey, come over. I have some meat of shlamim. Wow, let's eat it together." Sorry, I was not prepared for that. I went to the mikveh for truma, not for shlamim. So you think, like, what's the problem? The going to the mikveh is the same. You don't have like special, like immersing in the mikveh for shlamim or for like korbanot. It's the same going to the mikveh. So what's different? You already went to the mikveh. You pure enough to eat truma. So why shouldn't it be good also to eat shlamim? right? Answer is, there is a problem. Okay? You have to have the intention of what you're going to eat. You have to have the intention of what level of purity you want to achieve. Okay?
So do I always just go for truma?
What?
Do I always just go for truma? And that is for...
For us to have the intention to eat truma is a little bit...
it's complicated.
We're not...
Be purified,
yeah,
for everything.
Actually, by the way, it says that in time of Beit HaMikdash, the third Beit HaMikdash, so it will be like full atonement for Cheta Egel, for the golden calf, and then instead of the Kohanim, it will go back to the status of the firstborns. You know that it was supposed to be firstborns, and then because the firstborns did the sin, so Hashem gave it to the Kohanim instead. So there is some opinions that says that in the third Beit HaMikdash, it will be again the firstborns that will have the privilege of serving in the third Beit HaMikdash. There is a pin like that.
Wasn't the tribe of Reuben supposed to do the
No. Firstborns.
That's why to this day,
right, Reuben was a firstborn, and that's why he didn't get
it. I was like, yeah, kind of.
But it's not all the children of Reuben. Firstborns of all the tribes. Anyhow, so according to that, might be that they will have the privilege to eat truma. I don't know. Anyhow, the point is that this guy, he went to the mikveh and he didn't have any intention. Yeah? That's the guy that we're speaking about. Taval velo uchzak. What does it mean, taval velo uchzak? He went to the mikveh, he immersed himself in the mikveh, and he didn't have any intention. Maybe it was a hot day, he just went to cool himself. He didn't have the intention of purity. Yeah? So to eat truma, it won't be good. To eat anything else that is higher kedusha, won't be good. What about eating chulin? No problem, right? That's what it says here. Amrin ken mutar lechulin.
Just shlamim.
Right? Not shlamim. Chulin. Something that is not holy. It's not sacrifices.
Like we say about the
Netilat HaDayim. Right. Piresh Rashi Uchzak. So Rashi explains what does it mean Uchzak. That you have the position, halachic position of purity. Says Rashi Nitkaven. He had the intention. Okay. Katvu Rabbeinu Yerucham. So Rabbeinu Yerucham says Perek Bet and Chagiga. Nami Garsin and Tanu Rabbanan Notel Edav Nitkaven. So again, we're learning from the mikveh to washing hands, right? So also about washing hands, if you have the intention, you have the purity. You don't have the intention, you don't have the purity. Also, if you're dipping your hands inside of the mikveh, right? If you have the intention, it will be pure. If you don't have the intention, it won't be pure. But we have a brayta that says, benitkaven belo nitkaven, doesn't matter if you have the intention or you don't have. And after all, your hands are pure. Amar Rav Nachman lo kashya, kan lemaser, kan letruma. So Rabbi Nachman, Rav Nachman, he says, it's not difficult, it's not a contradiction. When we say it's not pure, it means for truma. For truma, it's not pure enough. Maser is chulin, it's not truma. So it's for that, it's pure enough. So then you can eat it. If he's there, and according to that, im lo nitkaven, im tosefta besamuch bechulin, hu, tosefta de besamuch bechulin hu, so according to that this tosefta, you know, by the way, you know that tosefta was written after the Gemara by Rabbi Yossi. It's not after the Gemara, it's parallel to the Gemara, but it's out, it's not the Gemara. There is the tractates of the Gemara, and in the back of the Gemara, you have Tosefta. Tosefta was Rabbi Chiya. So Rabbi Chiya is mentioned also in the Gemara, but he wrote like a set of books that is called Tosefta. Yeah? So generally, when we have a contradiction, we follow the Gemara. But some things, we have the, like we take into the Sefer because that's our source for a few points. Anyhow, if we say that the halacha is like the Tosefta, chulin, that we're talking about chulin, that there you don't have to have the intention. Tzarichu diktani tana kama until it dav mitkaven lav davka. So then, when we say that you washing the hands, you have to have the intention. It's not. It doesn't mean specifically have the intention. Otherwise, it's not good. Do adin afilu lo nitkaven. Because even if you don't have the intention, it's good enough. It's still pure for chulin.
So isn't that going back to the question of the five-year-old who has no intention?
That's a subject matter. From here, from one, we're learning about the other. Learn then, v'lo mikabel. So you don't have, not the person that gives over, and not the person that receives the water. Now, miyadav teorot, both, it doesn't matter, even if neither of them have the intention, the hands will be pure. And according to that, in the second chapter of Chagiga, that it says there, Notel yadav o matbila, u be'atzmo hi. So then, we say that there in Chagiga, we're speaking about that you need to have the intention. So there, it says that it's talking about the person himself. שלא נתכוון, הרי אין כוונה כלל. So if he doesn't have the intention, oh, ברוך השם. If he doesn't have the intention, and he's washing for himself the hands, so then, it will be, there's no intention at all. Right? If there's no intention at all, so then, it won't help. So again, when we said before, that there's two people, so, we must say that you're talking about a case that the one person have the intention or the other person doesn't have the intention. That one of them should have the intention, lechatchila. And here, when he's washing for himself, so if he doesn't have the intention, so no one has the intention, then it's not good. And then that's the source in Tractate Chagiga. Okay? So that's the way he's resolving the contradiction there.
So that sort of answers the question I had earlier. Well, one of the possibilities is that somebody doesn't have the intention of pouring or has only half an intention.
Yeah.
So if you have somebody else pouring, then you remove the possibility.
Okay. So he says about yourself, also if you having someone else that will wash your hands, and both of them don't have the intention, so Rabbi Yossi is so strong about having intention that if even one of them don't have intention, it's already out. It's not good. Okay? And we're not posting like that. We're posting like Tanakama. But the Eved not having the intention is okay. But we nikaven echad mehem, aval en achinami el Tanakama afilu lo nikaven echad mehem nami kasher. And then, according to Tanakama, even if neither of them have the intention, still it will be good b'dieved. And that's what seems to be the opinion of the majority of the rabbis, that you don't need to have the intention for purity. Anyhow, another side note about the mikveh, if you're going to the mikveh, so it's good to have the intention for the highest purity, right? Even though we're not going to eat kochim, I don't think so. Anyone? Not today.
You never know.
I never know. But right now, like it's 4:30. it will be a little, crowded there. anyhow. אבל הרשב"א כתב בתורת הבית לעניין כוונת נטילה. Okay, according to the Rashba, that it says about the intention of washing hands. You should have the intention for washing hands in a way that it will permit you to eat. So then, So if someone tells into the Sefer that if you have one person that you have the intention, the other person doesn't have the intention, your hands are pure. Rabbi Yossi Meir, Dav Tmeot, according to Rabbi Yossi, the hands are impure. Alma, Af Le Rabbanan, Kavanah Nodel, or Kavanah Noten Ba'inan. So the Rashba understands that according to the Rabbanan, not according to Rabbi Yossi, according to the Tana Kama or Rabbanan, so you have to have at least one person that will have the intention. So in Chulin, Kuf Vav, B, says there, Notel Adam Yadav Shacharit, Umatneh Alem Kol Hayom. You can have a person that is washing the hands in the morning, and he have the intention that it will stay pure the whole day. And that's obviously when he's guarding his hands, that not that he won't get impure. Dibresh Rashi and Rambam, like we explained, the opinion of the Rashi and the Rambam there, filu achi matne in lo matne lo. And even though he didn't touch anything that is impure, if he didn't have the intention that it will last for the whole day, it wouldn't. He have to have the intention. Right?
So in the morning when you wash
hands. Alma kavana ba'inan. So that's another source that you need to have the intention for washing hands. So if you have the person that is pouring the water or washing the hands, it's good. Right? So according to Rabbanan, it will be good. And we say the halacha is like Rabbanan, like, not like Rabbi Yossi. Rabbim Ninu, because we have a rule, Yichid v'Rabim, halacha k'Rabim. When you have argument of one rabbi and many other rabbis, so the halacha is like the many rabbis. Like the pro. So you can say another question from another source. There's a tractate called Machshirin in Tarot. So it says there, Maidel Perek HaShochet. So there it says that this Mishnah of Masechet Machshirin is brought down in the Gemara in Chulin, Lamed Aleph B. Perot Shenaflu Letoch Amat HaMayim. If you have fruits that fell into the water channel. Pashat mishi adav tmeot venatlan. A person that his hands is impure is putting his hands inside of the water channel to catch those fruits. Terot, his hands are pure. Vaperot terim, also the fruits are pure. Okay? Vekinanami minata, the lo bain and kavana. And according to that, you don't need to have the intention for chulin, right? Because this person, he had in mind just to grab the fruits. And by the way, his hand got pure. So even though he didn't have the intention, right? Says the Bet Yosef, Nirali Dei Lav Leachila Lechulin Kama. Here, says the Bet Yosef, he's not talking about eating chulin, Ela Negiya De Chulin. Talking about touching food that is chulin shenasal tara truma, that they were trying to keep this food of chulin pure like truma. Lolam leachilat chulin bainan kavana, and really for eating chulin needs kavana. It's the words of the Rashba, not the Bet Yosef. Excuse me. Tama mishum desrach trumai, and again the whole reason of washing hands is because it's extension of the concept of truma. It's ruach kavana ktsad, and it needs some intention. Kach nireh li ad kan lashono. That's what it seems to me, and this is the words of the Rashba. Af al pi shehoradim perek bet hachagiga delo bain kavana klal, says the Bet Yosef, even though I already proved from the second chapter of Chagiga that you don't need intention for washing hands. Efshar delo neichal el purushi. Maybe, so he's asking why the Rashba was not going in the same way that I did. Why he took a different way? So he says maybe he was not comfortable to give this explanation. Then I called myself that shenitkaven echad lashminan kocho de Rabbi Yossi. That when it says in the Tosefta that it's talking about one person that you have the intention, and Rabbi Yossi says that the hands are impure, so he doesn't want to say that this is the to show the strength of Rabbi Yossi. The Al Rabba, Havel Elamin Kad Belonit Kaven Echad Mem. It should be that it's not in the intention of one of them. And then to show that even in that case that one of them didn't have the intention, so Tana Kama says it's kosher. And generally we have a concept that kocha deter adif, the power of permitting is bigger. And also we have to have all of the strong opinion of Tana Kama, the Kaimal and Kavadeh, that we're holding to Tana Kama for Alaha. Ava Adif. And then according to that, that's what the Rashba explains, that Tana Kama permits only when you have one person that have the intention. Davka. So how can you, what do you say about the second chapter of Chagiga, that even when without the intention the hands are pure? That's talking about when he's dipping or washing his hands with someone else, that one of them did have the intention. Okay, the other guy, so he didn't have the intention, but the intention of the other guy is good enough. Yeah, to say that, like, dipping the hands with, like, by someone else, it's a little bit strange. Like, how does it work? Like, he's holding his hands and he's, like, pushing his hands to the mikveh.
Your
I don't know.
Will be pure, you know?
I don't know. Okay, it's stretching it, but that's what it says.
One guy is asleep and he...
To wash the hands of a guy while he's asleep. That's an interesting idea. Anyhow, but if none of them had the intention, pasul, it will be pasul according to the Rashba. And then according to that, when he's washing the hands of himself, so obviously he will need have to have the intention. Okay, now we have the privilege to read the words of the Shibalaleket. Amadbil yadav ben itkaven ben lo nitkaven. Someone that is dipping his hands in the mikveh doesn't matter if he have or he doesn't have the intention. Yetsa is exempt. What is the case we're talking about? Lechulin. If you're talking about chulin. But if you're talking about truma. Doesn't matter if you are washing or dipping. If you have the intention, you're exempt. If you don't have the intention, you're not exempt. According to Rabbeinu Binyamin, if somebody is washing the hands to eat, and his friend calls him, and he's wandering with his friend here, there, whatever, and then he goes back to his meal. He have to wash his hands again. If he's speaking with his friend and they're going further, so he have to wash his hand. That he's not saying that. Thank you. Again. I lost my place. Yeah, lo dami de'ad amar rav notel adam yadav shacharit. It's not, why it's not similar to the case that we said that a person is washing his hands in the morning and he have the intention for the whole day. Why it's not similar? De'atam, because there in the washing hands in the morning and having an intention, that tol aflig. Originally, when he's washing the hands, he have in mind that it will be followed later on in the day, eating sometime in the day, even though he will do all kinds of things. So because he have the intention, it makes it that by going further and doing all kinds of things, thank you, it will not destroy the purity of the washing of the hands.
But wait, let's wait a minute. When you wash your hands in the morning, you're not worried about eating, you're worried about it. You think that intention would change it? You can eat. It's asher to eat when you get
If we talk with we let's say a guy is traveling, yeah, walking. He made his camp for the night next to a water source.
Yeah.
Yeah. So then when he's starting to walk, he doesn't know if he will be next to another water source. So he wants that this washing that he's doing in the morning, it will be counted for the whole day. That whenever he will need to eat, he will be able to eat even though he won't find another source of water. Okay? So that's the case we're talking about. So in that case, he's washing the hands in the morning, not only to remove the evil spirit, is washing the hands in the morning, also for the eating that he will eat further on down the road. And that's fine. Yeah? In this case, it's fine. Even though we do say that it's good, it's better to wash the hands again, yeah, if it's possible, but it is permissible. Yeah, it's permissible. לעניין הלכה, אף על פי שהפוסקים לא הצריכו כוונה כלל לחולין, says the Bet Yosef, bottom line, even though the most of the rabbis didn't require to have the intention for chulin, לא כוונת נותן, לא כוונת נותן, doesn't matter if it is the person that is pouring or the person that is receiving, מכל מקום כיוון שלא כתבו בפירוש, because they didn't explicitly wrote it, שאינו צריך כוונה כלל, נקטינן כדיבי הרשבה, so we're going with the רשבה, meaning that you need the intention. I'm sorry, I forgot it.
Okay. What are you learning?
Netilat yadayim.
Okay, I can join. Okay.
Welcome, Baruch Haba.
Yes,
מה שאמר רבנו דגויה או נדע כשרים ליטל ידיים. What about a non-Jew or need a woman that want to wash the hands for someone? סוף נדע כתבו התוספות. We have a clear source in the end of tractate Nida, Ein Aleph B, that the Tosfot says there. יש רוצים לדגדג מנתניה מתוספת המסכת ידיים. According to the מסכת ידיים, there is those that want to be precise. כל שאינו מטמא את הידיים במסע. את המים. כל שאינו מטמא את המים במסע. Anyone that is not making the water to be impure when he's carrying the water, כשר לנטילת ידיים. His kosher is okay for washing hands. משמע מטמא במסע אינו כשר. So according to that, someone that is not, he will not be kosher. He will make the water to be impure if he will carry them. He is not kosher for washing hands. This is the diuk that to be precise in the words of the Mishnah. Yeah, that's what Tosfot says. מתוך כך אוסרים ליטול ידיים מן הגוי. And then they say, according to that, a non-Jew will not be allowed to wash the hands for a Jew. Says Tosfot v'shibushu. It's not true. It's not the right understanding. The anida v'yoledet not lot yaden. We know that a nida woman and a woman that gave birth that is also a nida, they can wash hands. Even though that if they are carrying something, it becomes to be impure. How much more so that all the water is impure because of the impurity of dead people. So says Tosfot that probably the source in Masechet Yadayim is talking about Tumah, because in their time they used to eat Tumah. Or lechulin shenasu al tara Tumah, or can be chulin that is done in the level of purity of Tumah. So in those cases, so then it requires a higher status, a higher level of purity. Can get up a Mordechi, also the Mordechi, he says the same thing. Ve'arabenu Shimshon. So, רבנו שמסון says, פרק כמה מסכת ידיים, תוספת הזו וזה לשונו, הכל קשרים ניתן לידיים, everybody are qualified to wash hands, אפילו תממת, אפילו בועל נידה, even someone that is impure because of that person that he touched that body, or someone that is living with a woman that she is נידה, כל שאינו מתמא במסע, anyone that is not making something to be impure by holding it, כשר ליתן לידיים is kosher to wash hands. כתב עליה, that's the Mishnah. כתב עליה, so רבנו שמשון writing on this Mishnah, זה לפי זה אסור ליטול מים מן הנידה ומן הגוי שגזרו עליהם שיהיו כזבים לכל דבריהם. That according to this Mishnah, it will be not allowed to wash hands from a nida or from a non-Jew, because according to the halachot of purity, they are making something to be impure. אפילו מן מת נמי אסור, and even someone that is impure because he touched a dead body, so still it will be not forbidden, not allowed. Clear mekabel tumah, because as long as he's using a vessel that is receiving tumah, receiving impurity, then he won't be allowed to wash hands with this vessel. Davka metamelet tmemet lakli, because why? Because the person that is impure from the dead body, so he's making the vessel that he's holding to be impure, and then when he's washing the hands, so the water are impure. נמצא כלי מטמא את המים ומפסיל לנילה, and then it makes the washing of the hand to be not good. כמו מכל המטמא במסע, and this is like anyone that is doing the holding something that to be impure. כמובן פרק ב' משמע בעד יד המים טמאים פסולים לנטילה, and also in the second chapter of מסכת ידיים we say that impure water are not good for washing hands. לפי זה אין תקנה בזמן הזה, and according to that, in our time, that we don't have pure water, so we don't have a way to wash hands. If a non-Jew is bringing water from the well, you can't wash from it. And even someone that is pure, they are called mim bazmanaz, everybody are impure in our time. And then everybody are touching the vessel, or mayim, and the water. So what do you do? How can you go out of it? יש מפרשים, so there is an opinion, there is explanation, that here we're talking about someone that is washing the hands for truma, right? And he's not talking about the case that he's washing his hands for chulin. And if you won't say so, how a nida woman can wash hands for herself? A woman that gave birth can wash hands for herself. They will make something impure by holding it. So there's in the duke, and you can't be precise about that.
How could they bake bread?
So obviously you can't say that. And he brings them the Marain Masechet Chulin Kuf Vav A Notlim Yadayim Lechulin Mishum Srach Turma. The reason we're washing hands for Chulin is because of the extension of Turma. Because the whole reason is because the extension of truma, and chiluk ben truma lechilun lechulin. So you can't say that there is a distinction between truma and chulin. So we have a contradiction here. We said the whole reason that there maseret yadayim we are stringent because it's talking about truma, and when we're speaking about chulin, you can be lenient. But he says, no, I can't say that. The whole reason you're doing the washing hands for chulin is because extension of truma. So if it goes with the extension of truma, so it should follow the rules of truma. So if there it's talking about truma and they can't wash the hands, so how for chulin they can wash the hands? So there's a certain problem here. Even though the nida is not eating truma, still there is the decree of the rabbis that everybody will wash hands before they eat bread, even someone that is not pure. Okay? So that's the kashya of Rabbeinu Shimshon. V'Rabbeinu HaGadol Ma'ari Abuab, right? The rabbi of the Bet Yosef, the Ma'ari Abuab. כתב שמפרש אחד כתב כל דברי רבנו שמשון. There is one of the rabbis that he copied all of those words of רבנו שמשון. ואחר כך פירש שהוא פירוש אחר בתוספת. And then he gives over his own commentary. שכל תמה שאם נגע בו אדם באצבעו, any person that is impure in a way that if a person, a different person, touches the impure person with his finger, יהיה כל גופו תמה, his whole body will get impure, ולא ידיו לבד, not only the hands, the whole body. דומיה דמת, the מת, for example, dead body, דתמה מת, ובל נדע, היינו תומה דאורייתא, for example, someone that is carrying a dead body, or living with a woman, need a woman, so this is תומה דאורייתא. כאשר ייתן לידיים, it is kosher for washing hands. אבל כל תמה שאם נגע בו אדם, you would have בלבד מאוד, but someone that if you touch him, only your hands will get impure. היינו תומד רבנן, so that it means impurity of the rabbinic decree. אינו כאשר ייתן לידיים. It is not kosher to washing hands. Okay? Sounds funny, right? Sounds upside down. How can it be? So there is a principle that he brings here. Sha'asu chizuk. There's a certain principle that you see a few times in the Gemara, that the rabbi, the sages made a strengthen their words more than the divrei Torah. Su chizuk le divreim yoter mishel divrei Torah. More than the words of the Torah. So sometimes something that is rabbinic, it is more stringency than something that is the writer. Okay? Usually it's not the case, but sometimes we say that.
What would be this case?
So he says that what?
What would be this case that the person gets impure just by the hands, just on their hands?
Basically every impurity which is rabbinic. That's not the point here. The point is here that is explaining the, in this way is solving the contradiction that we had. That can become mipnei she'atam shegazru b'yadayim. So here we're talking about the decree of the rabbis for washing hands. Mishum sraf turma, because of the extension of turma. Ve'ochlei turma prushim hem, and those that are eating turma are getting further from any impurity. Mikol turma deoraita, anything that is deoraita. So because they already have this instinct of being removed from anything that is impurity, deoraita, so there's no reason to warn us to keep purity there. But when you're talking about rabbinic impurity, so they don't have this instinct of being removed from this level of impurity, so then the rabbis had to warn us, to give us this extra push to make the effort to keep purity, which is rabbinic purity. And according to that, someone that is impure rabbinic tuma, so you can't wash you, he can't wash you your hands. Okay? That's the chidush of the Mari Abuab. According to the Rosh, Aidna Shekola Mayim Tmeim, that in our day that all the water unfortunately are impure, holy tol. You can wash hands, doesn't matter from who, non-Jew, neither woman, doesn't matter, because anyhow all of these water are impure. You can't do it purity, so doesn't matter. And so this is also the opinion of the Tosfot, and that's also the opinion of the two. That's another one of the Rishonim. Everybody are kosher to wash hands. Also a mute, full, and minor, but not from a non-Jew and not from a slave. It needs to come from a certain level of consciousness that they don't have. So therefore, it's not good to wash hands from them. Doesn't call them men. Okay. Ochot Chaim katab b'shem Rambam. According to the Orchot Chaim, in the name of the Rambam, En olim le'adayim migoy, that he says that the Rambam says you can't wash the hands from a non-Jew, nirah shedehu tsoferu. So he says that it must be a mistake. Sharei lo masinu sharambam katav ken. We didn't find anywhere in the Rambam that it says you can't wash the hands from a goy. Aval asmag v'atumah katvu kedivrei Tosfot v'arosh. Ben goy ben ida yachol litol mehem yadayim. Right? So the smag and turma agrees that also a non-Jew, also a needy woman, can wash the hands for you. Ken ela Rashba, Torah Dabayit, also that's opinion of the Rashba. Ken kaduruzu shuvot Rashba, la Ramban, also the Ramban says it. So basically that's what we follow, that you can wash hands from anyone, and if somebody wants to be stringent for himself, so that's his own choice, but it's not the halacha. Baruch Adonai leolam, amen v'amen.